you are able to view the presentation.
Yes, yes.
Perfect. So again, very good morning to everyone. Today we'll be talking on one of the data analytics tools from developed by Elsevier, which is known as RE-AXIS and RE-AXIS Medicinal Chemistry. This is a tool where you can utilize this for tool as a drug repurposing also, and that's the title of my topic as well today. So before I move on to more details about RE-AXIS and RE-AXIS Medicinal Chemistry, just want to touch base upon what Elsevier is doing in terms of novel coronavirus, and we have the information center as well. I hope Tehsin might also have shared this information to you all. But again, one more time, I'm just highlighting that. And you can visit this page and you can get the content related to all, coronavirus completely free of cost. You can even download those articles related to COVID-19 therapeutics. And this article is still now updated till May 15th, and it keeps on updating as and when we receive the articles from various publishers as well. If you go on to the next slide, this slide highlights the five drug development strategies to combat 2019 novel coronavirus as well. And this is from one of our reputed scientists who is now with Elsevier, named Dr. Anton Urwe. And you can go through this particular link as well to understand what he talks about in terms of the drug development strategies. And also you can visit his profile on LinkedIn. He keeps on posting various strategies and various developments related to COVID-19 on LinkedIn as well. So moving on to the next slide, I just want to highlight what RE-AXIS is all about. I am not sure if Tehsin has gone through, but just a couple of points here before I dig deep into RE-AXIS itself. So Elsevier is one of the RE-AXIS group of companies, and we are having 140 years of scientific knowledge, research experience, mainly as publishers, now converted into a data links, transforming into a data links company. Globally, we are present in around 180 plus countries, serving 30,000 plus, with 30,000 plus employees. And we do invest a lot in developing the technologies. And you can see around $1.5 billion annually is being spent for the improvements in the technologies. We do share a common purpose with all customer, which is to accelerate the science to improve the health. And in fact, what our promise is to the partner, to be partners to help your organization propel research and innovation forward and transform the way you bring new medicines to the world. And I think there is no better platform than all the pharmacy colleges coming together, where if they collaborate with each other, they can actually drive this COVID-19 therapeutics as well. Moving on to the next slide, slide five. This slide shows what the approach and the content we have from our experience, which is, like I said, 140 years of publishing experience. We do take that content, and with our own content and the content from our customers and the various publishers also, we then help them drive through all those with the data harmonizations and make analytics ready. And one of the examples you already seen how Scopus performs as analytic tools to understand the authors and researchers and how you can collaborate across the world. The next slide slide shows what we have to offer as Elsevier data analytics company to the pharma world or to the researchers specifically related to the biology, pharmacy, and chemistry areas. So if you see at the bottom of the slide, we do what content we have is coming mainly from Science Directs, which actually turns into various products such as Embase, which is used for biomedical databases, Pathway Studio, which is used for developing the targets, identification targets, and you can actually integrate your live experiments into Pathway Studio as well. Chemtiva is one of the tool which is going to upcome, where you can have the range of the complete discovery from preclinical starting phase to the clinical phase as well. Pharmapendium has is a product where you can have the data related to the preclinical to the post-clinical data package from pharmacokinetics and pharmacodynamics of any compound reported to FDA and EMA. COSA is a tool which is actually helpful for pharmacovigilance. And I will talk more about Reaxys and Reaxys medicinal chemistry. And Entelect again is a platform where you can do a lot of bio and chem informatics, and it is under development at this moment. So if you see the complete pharma life cycle, which is shown in the slide, is covered by all the Datanex tools provided by Elsevier. So before I start into details of what Reaxys is all about, as my title of today today's topic is regarding drug repurposing, just want to touch base upon what actually the drug discovery happens at the industry levels and how the medicines are discovered. So this is a very slide showing a little bit of information on ways to discover medicines, and you as a pharmacist coming from the pharmacy background might all know about this slide, but just want to touch base upon there are many ways to come up with a novel drug discovery, and nature provides us one of such platform where the active bioactive substances found in nature can act as a drug substance as well, which can be extracted from plants, it can be extracted from the organisms such as penicillins. Most of the research happens in the pharma drug discovery, which is a synthetic chemistry driven things, and also serendipity has driven the drug discovery phase as well, and you can see the examples listed here. Going on to the next slide, this slide shows when you want to discover a molecule which is first in class, what are the main is here, and if you see or in cell or animal model screening is one of the foremost driven area for the first in class compounds, and when your compound is second in class or follow up compounds, the target based screening approach is one of the approach followed which leads success to come up with the drugs in the market. So what the drug discovery cycle is all about? The first phase, as we talk, is the target finding phase, where researchers such as biologists come up with the target assays, target validations they do after that, and they need to develop those assays so that once your platform is ready, you can go and test your compounds. So this phase is called understanding disease phase. In industry, the first thing what the industry does is to do the market, help the marketing team understand the disease in the market, and will the company make money out after the 15 years of this whole process. So that's the first step in the whole drug discovery cycle. And then the next step comes in the target finding and target validation step. Once you do that, we have then a target, then the major pharma companies has a list of compounds with them stored in as a 20 molar stock solutions of a DMSO, which is stored at minus 20 degrees centigrade. There are thousands of compound libraries which is stocked there. Once the target is identified, they actually test all these compounds against a particular target with 96 12 plates screenings, and they come up with the hit, and from hit they find a lead out of that via the efforts of medicinal chemists, computational chemists, and from there hit to lead is happen. So when during this hit to lead process, a lot of in vitro assays has to be understood. The major thing is how in vitro assays potency can be transformed into the cellular potencies, and then subsequently going to the in vivo thing after you have the validated lead to get the efficacy of that particular compound against the target. So these are, I'm not going to a lot of details regarding what the detailing of each and everything happens during this creating molecule phase, but it is captured in the slide itself. And once the lead is identified, you have established the efficacy, you need to check that against various toxicity models. The toxicity can industry run in like 1 day, 4 day, 2 months tox, or 4 months tox as well, based on again the need of the target and what disease model is there prevalent there. They do open the pathology phase. This toxicity and followed by the safety analysis provides you with the information about the no observed adverse effect levels, and you will come to know what is the maximum tolerated dose and minimum efficacious dose of that particular compound against the target. Once you have that, and once you put those into the calculation, you will get to know you can information and extrapolate that information into what dose can be there, predicted dose for the human trials. You get all this data package, you submit it to FDA and get the investigational new drug application going on before hitting the phase one. And phase one is the phase where you do those studies basically in healthy individuals, again to understand the pharmacokinetics in humans, similar the way we did at the lead identification validation stage in the animal models. Once you know that you have good PK profile in humans, your compound is stable, safe enough to dose, then you basically go in and take into the phase two, where you actually dose that compound to the diseased individual with having that particular disease only. When you have shown that and you have proven the efficacy in the POC studies, you take that compound in the phase three, where that particular disease individual will have multiple ailments, and then you have to prove that particular your drug is also working in various ethnicities, various regions, the sex against male, females, everything is taken into account. And once you do that, you file that new drug application again with the FDA before before getting the nod to launch into the phase four, which is into the market. The phase four of the this clinical phase is a phase where you actually understand the disease in the drug initially in the patients which are actually in the trial mode running only, but they are the live actual patients, not monitored by the company in itself. Once you get those success, you actually keep understanding those data parameters of the adverse effects of those of the drug launched in the post launch phase of this particular cycle, and that is done known as a pharmacovigilance. Nowadays, a lot of software companies like Infosys, Accenture, they have their healthcare divisions which actually indulge into this pharmacovigilance studies. And as I told, our tool called COSA and COSA PVs are one of the famous tools used for this pharmacovigilance studies. So this is all what the drug discovery phase of the cycle is all about. And I just gave you the brief introduction about this just to make you understand how much time and effort and money is being placed into it, and why there is a need to understand it when you actually do your research. And as per our title of the talk, the drug repurposing is there. You need to understand the whole phase, discovery phase of the development of a drug. And then only you will able to appreciate, which is shown in the next slide, what the how and how much time is being saved in the drug repurposing of the finding the new drugs. And that's what is happening right now with the COVID-19. The drugs which are already in the market, which had shown efficacy for a particular ailment, now are being repurposed. And that's what the benefits of the drug repurposing is, that they will shorten your this timeline, and even if your cost of a development of a molecule for a particular disease, and in this case if you talk about the COVID-19, you can actually skip a lot of times, you because you have proven the preclinical species, the drug is safe, you just skip all those phase, you just do the in vitro testing against the cell lines of COVID-19, you see that your compound is active against it, and you can directly jump into the safety and tox studies against, saying that those are against smaller studies to see if your compound is showing efficacy and is safe for, and the pathologically it is not showing any adverse effects, and then take directly the compound into phase two rather than going into the phase one, because you know your compound is safe enough in the phase one itself. So this is how the drug repurposing takes lesser time, saves you cost as well, and you can get a drug quickly into market. And I will tell you in the later slides how Reaxys and Reaxys Medicinal Chemistry can really help you in this particular effort in finding new compounds for new indications or targets. So what I talked about is the industrial life cycle or industrial timelines for discovering a new compounds as a drug. But in academia, you don't have those thousands of compound libraries in hand, and you can test all the compounds when you identify targets. So what you require in academia is really a strong working hypothesis or an idea to act upon. You require models for either protein, DNA, RNA, cell tissues. And you need to develop those models to understand if your compound is active and efficacious on that one. You also require hands-on experience and availability on this particular test, which are in vitro tests. So you can, as a pharmacy institution, you can collaborate with the either the various labs which actually can provide you those assays, or you can develop those assays as well in-house, because in vitro assays are easy to run there. You then need the facilities. So pharmaceutical chemistry plays a role a lot of, so intra collaboration within the institute is will actually help you out to come up with synthesis of a compound. They will also understand what kind of structural development in a molecule can lead to a improving the activity and PK properties of a compound. You need STS thing, but again, this is not one of the things which actually a pharma company, the academic institutions can afford or have it. So either you collaborate with industries, or just on synthesis basis only you can make compounds. That's why you need a good pharmacophore model, a computational analyst who can actually run the analysis for you. For that, having a crystal structure with resolution of less than 3 angstrom, preferably 2.5 angstrom or less, is actually a necessity, because that will give you definite predictions of your models. And you can lead to good predictions, which will actually make a good active compound. You can actually, all those corporate often take all those IP from academia. So if you actually collaborate with industry, your IP is gone, and they, you will not get much of a holding on your compounds. So how you do start a drug discovery project without a specific target or STAs or lead structures? Here, actually, the Reaxys and Reaxys Medicinal Chemistry will help you out. And I have taken the example of the latest pandemic, which is COVID-19, to make you understand that. So what is COVID-19? You need to understand that. You need to understand its crystal structure. It is already in the database. You need to understand its models. Again, there are a lot of articles which have been published on that one. There is a protein structure. There are assays already there. So you need to understand what it is all about. You need to understand, does it have any sequence similarity with earlier coronaviruses or the SARS or the MERS virus? And it does have. It has around 97% to 98% of sequence similarity with SARS and MERS virus. You need to understand the mechanism of infection, if it's comparable to all those three viruses. And yes, the mechanism of infection is comparable with these viruses as well. Once you know this, then you need to know that these viruses own their viral proteins to alter the human activity, how the viral modulation of the activity of human proteins in the lungs can lead to these diseases and the death ultimately in the patient, how the infections against the SARS or MERS, what kind of efforts are in leading, and what are the mechanisms of action of these particular drugs which are being repurposed, or the vaccines which are in repurpose. You need to understand that when you search for the COVID-19 therapeutics. And then you need to understand like how the similarities of this virus can be a starting point for finding a molecules to develop these remedies against COVID-19. And what Reaxys and Reaxys Medicinal Chemistry offers is a complete platform where you can do the structure activity relationship using this information which I have already talked about, and then come up with your own molecules as a starting points to do the medicinal chemistry efforts. So before I go into actual demo session, I just want to provide you the information on what Reaxys is all about. So we started with procuring the Belstein or Belstein database, which is the organic chemistry database, and the Gemlin database, which is the inorganic chemistry database. So when I was doing my PhD at that time, neither SciFinder or Reaxys was there, way back in 2000. So that time we had the Belstein Commander, which we are using as a data analyst tools. So we elsewhere went ahead and procured that. We had our own content from Science Direct. which we utilize that to develop the tool which is used to provide a data in a structured way, intuitively understood by the chemist. We did and still do this by applying manual and automatic indexing tools. And recently, we also extend this to integrate customer proprietary data so that users are able to get the whole picture of the strategy. We are continuously developing it further into solutions and platform that will go beyond simple search retrieval as is. And all these things is now getting transformed into the intellect, which is a complete package as well. So what the content is all about? We cover around 16,000 journal titles with 7 patent notices at this moment. In 6 to 8 months of timelines, we will be adding 100 patent houses, because our own the RELX Group of company has total patents under their purview, and we are in a process of adding all the patent houses which are covered in the total patents. So there are almost more than 100 patent houses. So RELX will be one of after we add those, we will be the one of the biggest one Datanex tools to provide the complete patent houses which are there available there, apart from the content of 16,000 journal articles, which actually covers 59 million documents. So in depth, when you look at it, we have right now around 118 million substances which are integrated. They do are the starting materials as well, which are actually available commercially. We cover around 500 million experimental properties, and if you compare again with head to head with our competitor SciFinder, we cover more than 10 times the experimental data compared to the SciFinders. We cover around 49 million reactions, bioactive data points, target informations, in vitro, in vivo experimental data of animal assays, animal models. So everything which is required for a drug discovery development of a molecules is covered in RELX. So when we already understood the drug discovery phase, and if you know the starting point is disease target and compound and identification and development of the target or validating the target. So once you move ahead to the design phase, the more is the freedom to operate. What a researcher needs is the FTO, which is freedom to operate, understand the docking models, understand SAR, understand physical properties, understand match molecular pairs, and then you optimize the pharmacology to come up with a lead hit to lead to lead to progress the lead further. And from there, you actually keep on making the synthesis of the molecules. And this is a loop where it keeps on moving till you find the right compound moving ahead to the efficacy and followed by toxicity and safety cycles. So I have taken in this slide an example from our, which actually was provided by our customer, and how they were able to utilize RELX and RELX medicinal chemistry, which helped them from target-based screening till finding a lead, clinical lead there. And if you see how they have moved from left to go to the initial lead, and how they have modified that initial lead into a scaffold, which is a spirooxidol scaffold. And from there, they started getting help from RELX Medchem and their internal data, which helped them optimize potency, optimize the oral bioavailability, made the isomer more potent and stable, and then optimize further the PK to improve the dose projections to come up with the lead compound. So when you talk about the actual data, what we cover is we do have ADME and tox data. We do have CYP-HERG inhibition, AIMS data in it. We also help you understand activity, efficacy by the experimental data from the animal model and in vitro models. You also can understand selectivity, and I'll show you actually how you can actually see the selectivity as well. You can understand off-target activities from there. So whatever is required as a researcher, starting from identifying the target till taking it to the tox study, you actually have everything in the RELX and RELX medicinal chemistry to develop the compounds. I already captured this. Again, yes, the details of synthesis. you can have that information about NMR, HPLC, UV. You can actually know purification information, how you can run the HPLC purification systems. You have that information in the reaxes as well. And then you develop, you actually also search the novelty of a compound by Marcus searches. Neither the SciFinder, neither reaxes is the final when you talk about the novelty of a molecule in terms of patentability. So the STN search coming from CAS is the actually the final one where people use that to check if your compound is novel and patentable. When you talk about the content in terms of the experimental properties which I talked about, and these are all the experimental properties listed in this slide captured into reaxes. We have in-depth taxonomy again into reaxes medicinal chemistry, where we cover species, strains, species information, organs information, tissues information, cellular information, experimental model of in vivo in vitro assays, dose, pharmacokinetics, what is the dosing regimen. Everything is captured into reaxes in the experimental data form. Also, we also have went ahead as a professional services, and recently we have actually applied this, whatever you see in the slide, which is a comprehensive offer from reaxes, where we can integrate everything which you have at your place, where you have your ELNs, you have your sourcing compounds, where you have kept your starting materials, reagents, your commercial catalogs, your in-house activity profiling data, your chemical inventory. Everything can be integrated to reaxes in a searchable, one searchable platform. We have all already put actually you, in a process of implementing it at Jubilant Biosys, which is ongoing right now. What we have under development in terms of predictive technologies. So when you talk about this drug design cycle again, what we are in a process of implementing is the match molecular pairs in the predictive form. So when you go on to the next slide, it shows that when the reaxes content, we have already with reaxes and reaxes medicinally, we have collaborated with Swiss Institute of Bioinformatics, where we can start identifying the pair identification, and you can actually extract that information and how you can replace that particular pair with a right substitutions. And the content from us and the Swiss Institute of Bioinformatics help you to understand what kind of substitution patterns you can actually incorporate with the match molecular pairs. And the outcome is greater than 9.5 lakh molecular replacements available there. When you go on to next stage, which is optimized pharmacology, we are in a process of development of predicting the off-target activity. As you know, are aware that the target prediction by molecular similarity is based on the assumption that if two molecules are very similar, they are more likely to be active on the same target. So on that basis, when you have an unknown molecule, we have a molecule with unknown target, you search that similarity in reaxes medicinal chemistry and the library of compounds, whatever is available with the different targets, come up with the list of possible targets. And you can actually come up with the what kind of off-target activity is can be coming out of that particular searches. Once you are done with match molecular pair optimizing pharmacology, the main need is to synthesize the compounds. You can plan the route. Reaxes do cover retrosynthesis of known compounds with at least one penultimate state of information in reaxes in the literature database. But we also have come up with predictive retrosynthesis of unknown molecule. Anything you draw on paper, retrosynthesis tool will provide you the details coming up with that. So we have tied up with Professor Waller for this developing this tool, which is based on artificial intelligence and machine learning. So this tool, you will have the information of the what went into the collaboration and how the tool was developed by Professor Waller into this Nature article published in the year 2018 there. This tool helps you when you talk about our computer, it is more than 30 times faster because of the help of the AI and ML technologies. And also, it is not reliant on extracting and encoding rules by hand or manually. It is automatic there. So you can actually come up with newer routes very fast. These tags, whatever the commercial space available compounds there, we have everything has tagged into this tool so that it, whenever a new route is given, it actually starts from the starting material. But when if you want to develop it using your own intermediate SAN, you can actually do that. And our professional services team will provide you to integrate your in-house data, in-house starting materials or in-house intermediates for coming up with the new synthetic routes for unknown compounds. So how can you do that? So one such example, if you want to start it, you need to understand, as I told you, the structure and screening. You just read the literature about the structure of a compound. Take an example of COVID-19 here. Understand those aspects. And I was talking about sharing of the RDRP. So when you talk about the RDRP things, it shares around 97% sequence similarity with the SARS and MERS. So you, that can be your starting point to search molecules against SARS and MERS. And how you do that, we will now move on to the ReAccess tool actually to do to understand that. I will take you to that live. I will just start sharing my live platform with you. So this is how the tool looks like. So when you see that on the right hand side, I have logged into it. So once you log in, you and when you have subscribed to it, you can log in and you can create your profile. You can set up your UI based on your needs, and you can create alerts there as well in the history. You can, if you go to on the right hand side, just to ask, are you able to see my mouse cursor moving?
Yes.
Okay, perfect. Perfect. Thanks a lot. So if you see on the right hand, there is help section. When you click that, you will go and see the training videos or how you can utilize the ReAccess tool efficiently. So all the training videos and related information there in the help section there. You can go back to ReAccess by clicking there. So this particular search field, either you can draw your compounds or you can search by typing. The typo search works on natural language programming as it is there in the Google. So if you type three words in a letter, it will start showing you options. So as a researcher, when you are looking for one particular search item, but when you see popped up, there are 10 different items in front of you, you might want to have an interest in looking at that particular concept. And it can actually help you to understand that particular concept also. If you want to draw tools, we have ChemDraw embedded. Unlike SciFinder, we have ChemDraw embedded into ReAccess. So if you see, there is a MarvinJS tool, which is a drawing tool, and there is a ChemDraw drawing tool here. When you have ChemDraw, if you are not subscribed to ChemDraw at your end, still you can utilize ReAccess ChemDraw. You can copy paste from ChemDraw to PowerPoint, Word, any format, and vice versa as well, from PowerPoint, Word to ChemDraw in ReAccess as well here. The third option, which is the most favorable option, is to type to structure tool. So when you talk about the latest drug remdesivir, you just type the name of the compound, you will get the structure of the compound directly into ReAccess popped up. This will help you even do the substructure analysis. If you do so on the right hand side, if you see here, there are three options: as drawn, as substructure, or as similarity search. And then there are more options there down if you want to integrate those into your searches, right? So you can do those options. You can transfer this query directly into ReAccess, and not just the drug names. I will show you, you can actually have a very common names of a compound. You can have a dipeptide, tripeptide captured into ReAccess directly, and it will show you a dipeptide structure directly. You can have a glucose diacetate, a common name, or into it, and you will show GDA. So you can actually search that, and it will show you templates of glucose diacetate captured in there. This is something different coming up. So again, there is another molecule which is GDA. So you can actually search by common name. You can search by IUPAC name. You can say 1,3-propanediol or 1,2-4-oxadiazole or 1,2-propanediol or anything, and you will get those structures there. Let's see if oxadiazole is coming up. Yes, so You can get those structures via IUPAC name, common name, everything. This is one of the best advantage of FreeAccess there. The query builder helps you understand and do more complex searches. So I was talking about selectivity profile during my presentation. So I was just running a selectivity profile, and you can do that with multiple targets also. So if you want mTOR, a kinase, or then you can do that, and other target can be a MAP kinase, or so you can run those selectivity. PX is the logarithm scale. We have done it because activities in literature reported either in terms of micromolar, millimolar, PIC 50. So what we have done is we have used the logarithm scale, averaged them out to compare each other. But actually, when you go to the article, you will certainly get the actual data coming from the literature reference. So you can actually put the higher the number, the more active the compound is. So you can say 8 or 9 above PX value of this particular against this target, and you can run those searches directly. Either you find targets, or you can find substances, or you can find documents. So FreeAccess now will give you the compounds, list of compounds, comparing the selectivities of these two particular compounds against these two particular targets. And here are the list of compounds. Now, if you see on the left hand side, if you are able to view see my cursor, there are a lot of options again in the filter panel there. And these particular features are not at all available in SciFinder. You can go and choose the filter. You can select what exactly. Now we have only select two targets, but you can actually have the options. You can set parameters with the filter that what you are looking at it. You are looking at IC50s, inhibition rates, and there are more options into it. You can just drill down here, and you can go and select the options you want to zero down or narrow down your searches. You can actually filter them by substance classes, molecular weight, number of fragments, availability, available data, document type. If you are looking at any particular document type, that you can filter those things. If you see here on the top, you can toggle between the documents to reactions to the targets as well. And then the best part is to compare activity of these compounds with the selectivity profile. So you just run a heat map. You can show ask showing circle, so you can put targets on the x-axis, substance on the y-axis, and activity which comes in the PX forms. So if you see the axis also, you can change between bioassays, target species, biological species effect parameter. Everything is there, options, and then you just apply it. So you can do the SAR analysis between these two targets, which compounds are the most active against this, and you select one particular target.
Hello.
And you can
hello.
Yes.
Mandar, sorry to interrupt you. Can you increase some screen size?
I will.
YouTube viewer
can 150 is what they said indeed, right? So I will do that 150.
Right. Yes, please.
Perfect.
So, thank you.
Yes. So I will go back again just to show that. I will exit full screen. I will run this. The only thing is I need to move, which is yeah. So if you go and hit the full screen, you can actually sort the activity here. I think little bit lesser. Dr. Bhole, can you just check this particular screen size is okay with the YouTube, so that I can, it will be easier for me to handle it.
Yes, please.
This is okay, right? Yeah. So now, once you are seeing that, you can utilize still the filter panel on the left hand side, or you can actually go to a particular target, and you can actually say sort by activity. So now FreeAccess will help you to, once you sort that particular again that particular activity, it will show the top, the first compound will be the most active compound against that particular target. And if you want to view the details of that particular compound, you just go to the all substance details. You can go and see the information related to the that particular compound. So what FreeAccess captures is identification details, drug likeness. So drug likeness is following the Lipinski rule of 5 or not. So the blue triangle belongs to Lipinski rule of 5. And whichever the parameter of Lipinski rule of 5 it is validating, it will come out of that particular side, out of that blue triangle, the orange line will pop out. So right now this particular molecule is following the Lipinski rule of 5, where the hydrogen acceptor, donor, seal, lock piece, polar surface area, and rotator bonds are in the range. you can actually get physical data information regarding melting point, boiling point, if it is anything captured there. Here you see chromatographic data is captured here. Again, experimental data there in the location where it is located in the baton, you will come to know what is the retention time and purity captured there. You will see here, if you want to see the crystal property information captured in data, you will see what is the crystal pattern, yellow color crystals are there. And again, you will have the actual reference there. If you talk about spectral data of this compound, what is reported, they have one data point for NMR spectroscopy and one data point for mass spectroscopy. So we do not give complete chemical shifts here or spectra, but you will give you what solvent or what megahertz that particular spectra is. Is it a 1H NMR, 13C NMR? Is it a depth? That will come to know, and you will come to know the reference where you can actually find that particular data. But in terms of the mass spectroscopy, you will come to know what is the method of detection there, where the location is there in that particular, if it is a pattern information. So we'll come to know that particular information regarding spectral data. If you talk about the bioactivity data, as I was mentioning, whatever is captured for that compound, everything is reported. So here there are 344 data points. Again, it will be in tabular form. So if you are able to see, the PX value is there, but the actual value is also there, which is present there, is a 0.26 IC50 is there. And the reference for that compound, and it can show, keep on going to show you that one. Also, there are qualitative results. If you go down there, if you see here, the qualitative results are already captured. So what is the target? What is the effect? What is the substance action on the target? What is the assay description and the reference for that particular compound? So everything related to assay development or activity, in vitro activity, you will come to know, particularly when you see the bioactivity data. When you go about animal model data, which is in vivo data, you will come to know again all the information related to animal models and actual data. So practically a researcher do not have to even go and read the actual article in depth. If the data is captured here, you will get everything populated into ReAccess search in itself, right? So this is one of the advantage of that. You can export this data as well. So there are multiple options to export this data. You can do PDF data, XML, Excel file data is there, SD file data is there. So people who want to do chem informatics can actually export those data either into SMILES or SD files, and then actually do the run the chem informatics sessions as well. So this is one of the biggest advantage of ReAccess exporting as well. So this is one such example of a query builder thing. If you want to run a search, and we have also developed few forms for people who doesn't want to actually do on their own. So if you go to the form section here, there are ReAccess forms, which are chemistry based forms. So when you see that there is a bibliography information, natural product information, reactions information, spectral information. So if you want to see reactions, and if you click here on this one, a form gets populated on the left hand side, which is actually a design form for an individual. So you can add structure, you can add conditions, you can add catalyst information, you can add yield, solvent, time, temperature, pressure, all those parameters can be added into reaction condition. If you talk about the medicinal chemistry forms, again, pre-filled forms, you can have affinity on the target, cell profile, proliferation, selectivity profiles, animal model, tumor xenograft model, bioavailability. And if you want to see individually, rather than pre-designed forms, you just go to the fields, and you can keep adding those forms to it. If you want to talk about MedChem, you just go and see what kind of parameters you can add. So target name, substance action on target, substance effect, target nature, target mutant details, transinfections, substance route of administration. This is useful for pharmacokinetic people. Dosing regimens, substance dose, highest clinical phase, bioassay category, bioassay name, animal model, biological material name, species, clinical findings or disease things, organs, tissues, cell fractions. So whatever is maximum possible, everything is covered in the parameter. It has this particular query builder has greater than 500 properties embedded into its search form. Many. So we'll do one or two search. Before that, I will just want to show more things. So in query builder, you can actually, I'll just finish that query builder thing. So if you want to add coronavirus information, you can do that. Either you can search here. You can just, so coronavirus. So So Janigrahyam is Corona Virade. You can directly either go substances, documents, anything. You can do this way searching. Something, I think some problem is there. So there are 2,671 documents related to this. But if you go on the top, you will see there are 11,000 substances captured there, 19,000 odd reactions, and 147 targets related to that. Every particular information, you can actually do not have to even go there. You can see substances captured, what kind of substances in that particular articles are captured. You can directly go here. If it is reactions thing, if it is any synthetic procedures thing, you can actually see synthetic procedure directly there. You can toggle between this information as well, from documents to substances or reactions directly from here. You can see targets information there. You can see information on the single protein. You just click here, UniProt number is there. You go there, you will see the information on the protein. You will always see that against that particular area, which is the most active compound. It will be on the right hand side captured there. You will have target details. If any assay details are captured there, it will be there directly there. Inhibition data, if anything is captured, or bioassays or cell line information. I think again this 3C protein will be certainly there. Here is EC50 also captured on the right hand side of the bioactive molecule. Dr. Bhole, let me know how much time I have so I can wrap up as well.
You can continue for 10 minutes more.
Okay, perfect. So here you go, you have the information on this. On the left hand side panel, you can actually see, you can zero down to what target type you are looking at, if it is wild type or the mutated one. As there are more than 12 to 20, 15 mutations in coronavirus, you can utilize those information. You can actually zero down to what exactly the targets you are looking at for coronavirus, which can be related. So you can see 3C-like proteins, capsase 3, 3C-like proteases, all those things, RDRP. You can select those particular options and then you can limit to them, and you can show, ask them to show that particular information through reaxis. So you can actually, once you select that, you can limit to. So now we will see about RDRP's information only, where there are 212 substances reported against RNA polymerases, RNA dependent RNA polymerases. You can see that information there in terms of document. Again, you will have for each particular compound, you will again see all those information related to physical data, spectral data, drug likeness, preparations, reactions. So if you want to see reactions, you can see directly, go ahead and see the reactions conditions is will be there. You can directly see. And if you want to see only the if you want to see hide conditions, you can just click a tab. You can utilize that particular option and only reactions will be popped up there. That is one of the advantage here as well, you, which will unclutter your information. Also, you can ask reaxis to show only the information where the experimental procedures are captured in reaxis. So you can limit to that. So out of 29 reactions, there are 12 reactions where the experimental procedure is directly captured into reaxis itself in a tabular form again. So you can click there. And again, the actual data points are there. You can go to the literature, actual literature examples as well. So reaxis basically helps you understand the SAR, come up with your compound. I have not touched base upon the drawing tool more efficiently, but I will just give you a small example in the next 5 minutes, just to tell you how powerful the reaxis drawing tool is as also. So if you see here, I think I will just reduce it for a time being, the size. I'm not able to the screen has been smaller here. So Dr. Bhole, I will just reduce it for time being.
Yes, okay.
So that I can show you the maximum properties. So if you want to do a very generic search options, you can do that. If you see here in the periodic table, if you click that periodic table, there is option called atom in the list, atom not in the list. So you can actually ask first I have to select that atom not in the list. So when I see not in the list and say nitrogen, oxygen, chlorine, bromine, fluorine, and if I say okay and put that here, so now REACC search result will yield you the results without these particular elements or their functional groups in REACC. So you can utilize either in the list or not in the list. So I'll show you only one out of those two just for showing the examples. And whenever you run those substance searches also, you will see this unsegregated information where segregated information where you can see substances, target information, average similarity substances and reaction information related to those compounds directly into REACCs. So if you see now, all the results will be without those functionalities directly. And again, for every compound, the UI is set in such a way that you see information related to its activity, like in vitro, in vivo data points, metabolism data points, or physical data points as well. And again, for every compound, there are preparations, reactions, targets, everything identified. You can run a heat map analysis for every compounds there. You can utilize the left-hand side filter panel to do that. I will go you just again, I will edit the search. Now, if you want to do a very generic search, say, if you utilize that, you can actually set what substitution pattern you can utilize. And the good part is that if you put it as a smart R functionality, you can actually now utilize functional groups directly. You can draw those functional groups. Utilize, say you want to have a secondary alkyl. So you can put that as R smart R group. If you want to have a ketone or aldehyde drawn there, you can do that. And the drawing is very simple. If you again compare with a competitor, and I was the user of that for years as well. So I will show you a small couple of examples. You can club that and you can set this as R. Now you will show the when you hit transfer query and search it, you will see the results with this further functionality on the benzene. So you can utilize for specific searches as well directly. This is much more powerful search. Till it pops up, I'll just take you down here. And every particular thing, you have hits and conditions directly into REACCs. So you can compare there, you have actual reference also coming out from there. So if you say show all hits or show all condition, this table will completely pop up. Now you have all these conditions where 95% yield. So same way you can filter out, use filter panel using sorting out what best catalyst is option is there, or which is the best solvent option is there for running Suzuki reactions. You can zero down to this. You can say catalyst classes, solvent classes, reaction classes. You can actually do those options and then zero down to get the best possible search hit, where you can run that experiment at your end to get maximum efficiency out of your reactions. So REACCs helps you not only in designing your reactions, conditions. I will just show you one now with a retro synthesis. So let's take an example of remdesivir also and see if we are able to find. So if you go to history, whatever the searches we have run, it will pop up here. You can now set alerts. You can save them. You can edit them here. You can set alert, email alerts to it so that whenever suppose you want to search, put alert. You can say after each update, REACCs will show you, send you an email or it should be a monthly, bi-weekly, weekly option. You can do that to set alert so that you do not have to find again and again the same thing here. So let's search the remdesivir. Yeah, I think we have searched view. So let's take this example. Let's see if we are able to find the retrosynthesis for this particular thing. So Reaxys can create 10 different plants for synthetic plants for you. You can actually have a linear or a convergent synthesis, and you can actually ask Reaxys to stop the searching if the starting material is commercially available. If you say no, it will go to a smallest possible starting material. You can modulate the expected yield or a given yield, reported yield of a reaction as well, and you create plants. So let's see for this molecule, if it is reported, we'll come to know any synthetic plants are available or not. So if you see here, this molecule is there and we got a retrosynthesis of, see, if you see, a smallest possible starting material will be captured here on the left hand side. And for every step, you will have a condition, literature reference. So if you click this three dotted line one and say show conditions, at the bottom it will show, or you click this particular window, it will show on the top. So with experiment procedure. So every step you will have the experiment procedures captured into Reaxys. So you are assured that your retrosynthesis plan, whatever has been captured by Reaxys, will certainly work. And this plan can be novel in and may not be reported as it is depicted here, because Reaxys runs their artificial intelligence platform. It will tap those molecules from various articles and it will create a own, might create a own plan itself. But for every step, you will have the synthetic protocols to execute the reaction at your end. So this is how retrosynthesis looks like in Reaxys as well. So I think that's it from me to just show you a brief about how what features Reaxys have and what capabilities you can utilize from Reaxys to run your research projects. So I'm open for the questions, Dr. Bore.
Thank you so much, sir, for such an informative talk.
So what do you, Anaga?
Thank you so much, Mandar, sir, for such an informative talk. So can we have some questions now?
Certainly.
Sir, the first question is from Dr. Manoj Kumar Mishra. I will unmute him now. Hello.
Yes.
Yes, Dr. Manoj, sir, you are unmuted. Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Yes, sir, you can ask your question. We move on to the second question, which is from Falgun Mehta.
Hello, hello.
Yes.
Hello, hello, sir.
Yes.
My question is that whether it is a we can install it in the computers, or it is a free for the academic or researchers.
So this is not a free tool, certainly. For you need to subscribe to this tool. But if your institution has subscribed, it's not required to install. It is any browser tool. Any browser you can access Reaxys. Even you can access Reaxys mobile. If you are on the same IP of the institution and subscribe to it, you can actually access on mobile as well. But you need to subscribe to it.
Individually, also you can do that.
Actually, there is no right now available platform to provide for individual researchers, because it might cost you more. But you can contact me and you can take it offline.
Okay, sir.
I will just share my contact details as well.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, sir. The next question is from Falgun Mehta.
Okay.
Yes, sir, you can ask your question.
Thank you. My question is very simple, and it is related to the first question that was put to you. How do we access Reaxys? The question is simple, but there are a lot of ramifications to it, and I would like if you can address all of them. Does it work online? Do we need to download it? Is there a primary version which is free for you so that we get used to it, and then ultimately we subscribe if we feel like And will the subscription be available in rupees or will it be dollars like we usually see on the Elsevier sites?
Okay. So to answer the first couple of questions, yes, you can actually, you don't need to install it first. It's accessible through IP on any browser, web browser. It can be Mozilla, Google Chrome, Internet Explorer, or even your mobile browser also, if you are actually on the IP of the institute. Okay. It's not freely available, but yes, if you are interested in it, we can provide a 15 days trial after our management approval to your institute. You can utilize that, analyze it. We can run a training session separately for you in depth training session so that you can use it efficiently. And then you can put a decision for subscription and we can work on the pricing for your institute. Right. And what was, I think I have answered all your questions.
Thank you, sir. Next question is from Dr. Kumaran.
Yes.
Yes, sir, you are unmuted. You can ask your question.
Sir, it's a very good session. I want to know from this reaction, can we get docking data?
You cannot get the docking data because that is a separate tool in itself, right? You need to do docking at your end. But yes, the game informatics thing, what you are doing it, the SAR analysis part, you can do it in ReAccess itself.
SAR only we can do it.
Yes, you cannot do the docking because that is a separate software for doing the docking.
Yeah, that I know. That's what, if we get that data, it is also very good at all for doing research. That's what I'm asking. Okay, yes. Sir. Thank you, sir. Thanks. Sure. Thank you.
Hello, sir. Can we have two more questions?
Certainly.
Sir, this is the question from YouTube. Vrushali Neve ma'am wants to know how the synthesis planner in ReAccess works.
So it works on artificial intelligence thing. So when ReAccess search, at least one report should be there or literature reference should be there for that particular synthesis of a molecule, at least its penultimate step. So what ReAccess does is that based on its artificial intelligence platform, it taps all those intermediates linking to a synthetic route, possible route for a particular known compound. And I had already captured in my presentation that we have a separate tool, which is a retrosynthesis tool for unknown compounds as well. So you draw anything on your paper, you can get it there. That is based on the machine learning and artificial intelligence.
Thank you, sir. Last question. Miss Malti wants to know, whatever you have explained in this ReAccess in your presentation was about and for a synthesized molecule, but is it same cycle line for final developed formulation also, or is it something different?
So what do you mean by final developed formulations?
Like ready formulation.
So yes, whatever the experimental data is there available, it will be captured in ReAccess regarding any compound, any formulation as well.
Thank you, sir.
But no, it and then you can take the insights from that when it is a closed structure. Suppose you want to run a formulation or run an analysis or run a purification, you can take its do a substructure search or similarity search, and then you can take that information from the closest possible structure to apply for your own new entity.
Thank you, sir. Sir, Dr. Asha ma'am wants to ask you one question.
Sure.
Asha ma'am.
Good afternoon, Dr. Mandar. That was an excellent session you gave. So as we understand, therefore, this tool is a big weapon in the hand for medicinal chemists to design new molecules. But I wanted to know that once we use this platform and collect the fragments using all the data available in your ReAccess platform and build a new structure, for a new structure, what are all the predictions that are possible using your tool?
So in terms of a new structure, you cannot have all the predictions there coming directly from that structure. But as I told you, you can run the similarity search of a compound and the closest similar possible structure, the data, whatever is available, you can take insights from the data. And either if you're looking at the development of in vitro assay, you can do that. If you're looking at addressing metabolism, you can do that. If you are addressing the pharmacokinetics things, you can do that. all those related informations. That's what researchers do for doing a novel thing. You get the right information closest to a possible structure you are looking at it, and then embed that information into your compound so that it the reality is coming in place. So that's what the ReAxis gives you, the power to analyze everything at one place using the similarity platform or a substructure platform.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Sir, one more last question.
Sure.
From Dr. Bandhu, sir. Sir, you are unmuted and you can ask your question.
Hello. Yes. Good afternoon, sir.
Yes, sir.
My question is that can researcher use blend of ReAxis, molecular modeling software, and last in vivo assessment for activity for drug development using drug repurposing principle, and how it will be useful for drug development, sir?
Okay, so ReAxis using you have in vivo model in place, so you can certainly do the drug repurposing for sure and drug development with the help of ReAxis medicinal chemistry. If you you have a hold of that particular target, you will get all the related information of assays, in vitro assays on that particular target. If that particular target is already there, known, you can, and if in vivo data is there, you can actually create those models for you. And the designing part for synthesis molecule, you get procedures from ReAxis. You can get retrosynthesis of designing compound or synthesizing a compound with more number of steps as well in ReAxis. So all those related information for either a drug repurposing or even carrying out a new drug development is provided in ReAxis for sure.
Thank you, sir. I have another one question. Can
sure.
I ask?
Sure.
Sir, actually, for publication, we are using three journals. And so what is difference in we should go for Science Paper, Science Direct, or any other? How should go further?
I didn't
for citation.
Can you repeat your question, sir?
Sir, actually, there are so many there are Web of Science, Science Direct, all these are search engines. So how for guru citation, how should go for a publication? Because we are going for most of three journal publications.
Okay. So what you are looking at it exactly? You want to publish an article in a good journal, you are asking? So can you what is the exact question?
Yes, exact that.
Okay. So if you're looking at publishing your content in a reputed journal, so you might be looking at those particular journal, you know what content is in that particular journal, and you can actually try to assemble the data in a way you can publish in a good journals where you can get more citations. Again, citation doesn't depend on the very high impact journals you have published, but the work what you have done is not been actually followed currently, then it might not be cited very well immediately. But if the work is important, it will certainly citation. So citations is completely different from the quality of publications also. Citations will come over a period of time. But yes, if you are right now, say you are working in the COVID therapeutic area of drug repurposing and you publish an article, it will actually capture more number of citations immediately because you are working on a content which everybody is right now looking at it. So that is what citations will give you. But the quality of publications certainly will fetch you the higher impact factor journals if you have good content about it. And you will get certainly the citations later on as well to add it to your publications. And the content, that's what, if you do your research through a good search engine, you will certainly get good content out of it because your searches will be thorough enough to come out with a novel idea to pursue in your research activity.
Thank you, sir. Sir, the last question is from Dr. Vandana Patravali, ma'am. Ma'am, you are unmuted. You can ask your question.
Thank you, Dr. Mandar, for that lucid presentation, as well as being gracious enough to extend the support of trial for those private colleges who would like to actually utilize this tool. Now my question is, since we are moving towards biologicals nowadays and the molecular size is very huge, so in the design element, is there any limitation with respect to molecular size currently?
Very nice question, madam. Yes, we are certainly looking at adding the biologics data to REAXIS as well. So that will certainly come up by mid 2021. But right now, we don't cover the biologics data in terms of designing of the part, say what proteins are there or what is the assay information, if they have reported anything. Right now we are not covered it, but yes, you can certainly search in the text search, and whatever the document related information you get through REAXIS, you will certainly get it, and you can accept it at your end. But the way the UI is captured right now is only for the small molecule space.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, sir. Sir, actually, we have many more questions in the list, but because of time constraint, we cannot take all of them.
Yeah. If you want, I can go ahead with a couple of questions also. No worries.
Okay, sir.
If you have time, yes, I can certainly go with you.
So the next question is from Sugandha Mulgund, ma'am.
Yes.
Hello, ma'am. Sir, she's not there. So to proceed, thank you so much, Mandar sir, for solving and clarifying all the doubts and queries of participants. With this, I now request Dr. Ritesh Bhole sir to please conclude this session. Please, Ritesh sir.
Am I audible?
Yes.
Thanks, Mandar, for such a nice session. Actually, in a corona era, the REAXIS may act as a nuclear weapon to fight with the coronavirus. Dr. Mandar's session start with how to discover a drug and what is the exact discovery cycle of a drug from target finding to the launch of a drug. Dr. Mandar also highlighted the difference between traditional drug development versus the repurposing of a drug. And also let us know about the innovative tool REAXIS, its feature, and how it would be helpful for repurposing in post-COVID era even. Once again, on behalf of Dr. D.Y. Patil Institute of Pharmaceutical Sciences and Research and Association of Pharmaceutical Teachers in India, I would like to thank Dr. Mandar for such an enlightening session. Thank you once again. Now I hand it over session to Dr. Sejal for next proceedings. Dr. Sejal, please.
Yes, sir. Good afternoon, everyone. Here we come to an end of day two of EFDP on building research and innovation culture among pharmacy teachers, jointly organized by Dr. D.Y. Patil Institute of Pharmaceutical Sciences and Research, Pimpri, Pune, and the Association of Pharmaceutical Teachers of India, APTN. Few instructions I'd like to repeat. Use your 4-digit registration number for submitting assessment and attendance. All the communication links about attendance and assessment will be through WhatsApp group only. Attendance link will be open for 2 hours during the session. Assessment link will be open till next day morning, 8 a.m. Minimum 60% should be obtained in the said assessment. For tomorrow's session, all are requested to join 15 minutes earlier, that is at 10:15 a.m. for seamless experience. For tomorrow, that is day 3, we have 2 sessions by eminent personalities. First session by Dr. Prashant Murumkar, who will be talking on computational tools in accelerating drug discovery. And second session by Dr. R.V. Chikle, who will be discussing about basics of research publication, impact factor, and indexing. So we'll meet at 10:15 a.m. tomorrow to continue our learning. Till then, stay safe, stay healthy, and have a great day ahead. Thank you. Thank you all.
Thank you.
Thank you.